One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Can a local bank provide all the big bank services with the friendliness of a small town neighbor? Waterstone Bank has been doing it for more than a century. This is your Waterstone Bank, and we're invested in the community, supporting education, women's and youth programs, and honoring our brave veterans and frontline heroes. We're at the heart of it all. Welcome to your Waterstone Bank.
Welcome back, Susan. How can I help you today?
Learn more at WSBOnline.com. That's WSBOnline.com. Member FDIC.
WTMJ's Vince Vitrano for Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin. Injuries happen, but you don't have to play in pain or stay on the sidelines. Whether it's your kids dealing with a sports injury, college athletes, or the rest of us weekend warriors, the experts at Orthopedic Associates of Wisconsin will quickly diagnose your problem, lay out a treatment plan that works for you, and get you back in the game. They fixed my knee. My mother-in-law is back on the dance floor with a new hip. These are the experts you can trust. Visit orthowisconsin.com.
How do we keep our prices so low? That's easy. We've removed the middlemen. Yep, most landscape suppliers have a couple of them in there, and that's okay. But each one of those men in the middle means a higher cost for your mulch, decorative stone, flagstone, and boulders. Feel free to check around. For the quality of our products, you won't find better prices. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. You know, most mulch is reclaimed from landfills, but Erickson's mulch is grown from whole trees. Yep, we process the mulch ourselves to keep the prices nice and low, and use only premium colorant so the beautiful look of new mulch lasts. At Erickson's, we never skimp, and that's why first-time shoppers become repeat customers. Erickson's Landscape Supply. High quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection.
The place you want to go, Lynch McGuanago.
Nobody sells for less than Lynch.
WTMJ, W277-CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee. From the Annex Wealth Management Studios, this is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station. Trusted, relevant, locally owned, locally programmed. We are Wisconsin's radio station. News Radio 620, WTMJ Milwaukee.
At 1 o'clock, it's 34 degrees, decreasing clouds today, cool and breezy with a high of 41, chilly tonight with a low of 25. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Greg Matzik. A federal lawsuit accuses a Milwaukee Public Schools principal of abusing a first grader for having gay parents. Milwaukee French Immersion School former assistant principal Kasongo Kalambula allegedly told the student his parents would, quote, burn in hell, and at one point threatened to kill the student if he told anyone about the abuse. The criminal complaint says Kalambula would lock the student in a dark room for hours and failed to protect him from bullies. The student, now in psychiatric treatment for trauma and anxiety. Meanwhile, despite the allegations, Kalambula promoted to acting principal of French Immersion. He is currently the principal of Mary McLeod Bethune Academy. A child struck by a stray bullet on Milwaukee's north side. The parents of 6-year-old tell TMJ4 News the child was playing video games in the living room when a bullet came through the side of their house at 38th and Villard. Family members say they expect the child to be discharged from the hospital later today. Milwaukee police continue to seek unknown suspects. More details about the six people who are presumed dead when the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore collapsed. CBS Nicole Skanga.
The Guatemala Ministry of Foreign Affairs confirming that Two individuals from Guatemala are among those unaccounted for and presumed dead. The Mexican consulate not giving a number, but saying that they too believe that among those who are missing are presumed deceased.
Federal investigators have recovered the Voyage data recorder from the cargo ship. Waukesha County is considering a half-cent sales tax to keep up funding big-ticket budget items like the Sheriff's Department. County Executive Paul Farrow tells Wisconsin's Afternoon News the consideration is not because of Milwaukee County's sales tax increase.
We're in a different position. Waukesha County, third largest county, we have the lowest spending of any county in the state per person. So I think we're very fiscally prudent, but we still have high level of services. We've been able to balance that out. The challenges come in. We're capped by how much property levy we can have.
Farrow says Ozaukee County is the only county in Wisconsin with a lower tax rate than Waukesha. Longtime editor-in-chief of the Milwaukee Business Journal, Mark Cass, leaving in mid-April to join Milwaukee sports media firm Team Lamy as a senior executive. Cass also becomes the executive director of the Wisconsin Athletic Hall of Fame. Milwaukee Business Journal says the search for his successor will begin immediately. More information at WTMJ.com. Cass scheduled to join Wisconsin's Afternoon News today at 5:15. And the Brewers are ready to play some ball and give back to Milwaukee. Vice President of Community Relations Katina Shaw tells Wisconsin's Midday News her spring training prep was not all about baseball.
Each month we're out in the community working hands-on with several nonprofits that we partner with. We build houses, serve underserved families, we visit schools, you name it. We have our hands in just about everything.
And the Brewers scheduled to begin the regular season tomorrow in New York. The home opener is scheduled for April 2nd in Milwaukee. Time for news about your money, the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management Market Update. All the indices in the green today. The Dow currently up 258 points at 39,540. The NASDAQ up about 10 points at 16,325. And the S&P 500 up about 16.5 points at 5,219. Annex Comprehensive Wealth, Annex Private Client, Annex Ignite. Financial planning at every level. For details, visit annexwealth.com. Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 105.
Before you go looking for an area rug that you'll have to settle for because you think that the one you really want will be out of your budget, come to Design Exchange, where you'll find a formidable selection of Oriental, Persian, and other wool area rug choices at 25 to 70% off retail. This is Katie with Design Exchange, where discerning buyers with discriminating tastes come to find premium home decor on consignment at a value. Design Exchange in Heartland and Pewaukee.
Design Exchange.
If you're trying to find really good, high-end, distinctive furniture, the kind they just don't make anymore, then come to Design Exchange. But you better get here quickly, because the best furniture we take in on consignment doesn't usually last long. It may be vintage, it may have once been out of your range, but now you'll find it's priced right. This is Katie with Design Exchange, where discerning buyers with discriminating tastes come to find premium home decor at a value.
Design Exchange.
Burkhart Sporting Goods has a great reputation for producing custom team apparel. We're total team outfitters and we can handle the biggest jobs. Our success in custom team apparel led us into group and corporate apparel. Plus, we have a full selection of promotional products for employee gifts, special events, you name it. And we've made it easy for our customers to firm up their orders. The group sale web stores that we build for our customers are a simple way of gathering all the information you need. They're easy to work, easy to understand, and with them, you'll have access to nearly limitless options. We've seen that most times we're better priced than our competition on the same high-quality apparel choices that the other guys offer, plus Nike and Under Armour choices that the other guys can't get. And we offer a huge brand selection from Yeti, North Face, and Carhartt, too. This is Brian Burkhart. For team, group, or corporate custom outfitting and promotional products, it's going to be really hard to beat our prices, selection, and ease of buying for any size budget and every size company. And that's why we always say,
you can't beat Burkhart.
New Berlin and Fox Point.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All sports desks. Brewers finished the Cactus League season with a record of 16-15. Wheels up to New York's scheduled opener tomorrow against the Mets. Rain in the forecast, however. Friday is an open day on the schedule. Brewers' home opener is scheduled for Tuesday, April 2nd. And the NFL announces it'll play two games on Christmas Day this season. December 25th is a Wednesday. And according to Packers president Mark Murphy, the team should find out in the next several days if they will open the upcoming season against the Eagles in Brazil. Taking a look at your roads with the WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver Traffic Update. 43 southbound Brown Deer to downtown, a 3-minute delay. It'll run you 14. Westbound 894 Mitchell to Hale, normally about a 6-minute ride. It's going to run you 9 today. Otherwise, standard travel times across the system this afternoon. Cool and breezy today with a high of 41, wind gusts up to 25 miles an hour, mostly clear, chilly tonight with a low of 25. The sun returns on Thursday with a high of 45 degrees. In Madison, it's 34, Green Bay 31, Waukesha 33, it's 35 in Milwaukee. I'm Greg Matzik, Siding and Limited, WTMJ News Time is 109.
65,498 square miles. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get to it. This is Spanning the State. Here's your host, Kristen Bride.
Good afternoon. Coming up today, housing prices continue to rise faster than incomes. So my question is, who is buying these houses? And then it was some pretty big news yesterday for Wisconsin unions. And are you going with a potato or an egg this weekend? Happy Holy Wednesday, Steve Scafidi.
Happy Holy Wednesday.
Happy Holy Wednesday. Maybe we should replace Hump Day with Holy Wednesday.
At least this week.
At least this week.
That's, you can't do both at the same time.
Do you have big Easter plans?
Yeah, everybody comes to our house and eats our food and drinks our alcohol.
So territorial. Our food, our house.
My wife does all the cooking. I do all the setup.
And the cleaning, I imagine.
We share that duty.
Okay.
But you know, it's all the family, you know, both sides.
When it's both sides, how many people is it? In total. It's
gotten into the 20s. It's close to that.
Because you're one of four.
Yes, and then Kathy's one of four as well. And then you throw the grandkids now, and then my son-in-laws, and there's a lot of people.
Yeah.
Aunt and uncles involved. Yeah,
that's a lot of people in not having outdoor space, and unless it's supposed to be nice this weekend. Of not being able to shuffle some of those people outside. It's a
typically
lot of people in
we
one house.
Do that. Yeah, but this year I don't think so.
Okay.
It's squishy outside.
It is squishy.
Yeah, like way too much rain. No. Inside. But we got plenty of room.
All right. Well, have you ever been deceived by artificial intelligence? Has there been any kind of deep fake or altered photo that you thought was real?
I thought that Pope one was real.
I thought the Pope one was... No.
With the puffy coat.
The puffy coat.
Yeah,
big white puffy coat. So he made him look like he was a rapper.
Right. But I could see him. Like he's an older person. You get cold. Let's put the extra puffy...
He lives in Italy. There's a lot of fashion there.
Let's put the Pontiff puffy on him. Right?
So that one you kind of fell for.
Yeah, some Tom Cruise ones too. Right?
Okay.
Because he had a bunch of stuff going around where he was saying things... Like the real Tom Cruise probably wouldn't say. I think that was a big deal, right?
Which is saying something, because I feel like Tom Cruise, circa 15 years ago, saying a lot of crazy things.
I think he still does. Yeah. Good actor, though. Great actor. Yeah.
Incredibly hard worker, apparently.
Yeah.
He runs to set. So he runs from his trailer to set, and his response, whenever a new person asks him why he does that, he's like, why would I walk when I could run?
True or false? Every movie he's ever made, he's sprinting at some point down a street or a road in those films.
I don't know if it's everyone, but I've seen the...
With the very sharp movements.
The compilation of how many times he actually has done that.
And from all accounts, from people who have known him, strange dude. Very strange dude. I'll leave it at that.
Leave it at that. All right. Well, I bring this up because, as we know, as we talk about all the time, AI is here. And will likely be used in political ads this year. But at the very least, a new Wisconsin law says that if AI is used in a political ad, it at least has to be disclosed that there is AI involvement. So when we come back, we're going to talk to one of the bill's co-authors to find out what the bill actually does, when it goes into effect, and if he thinks it goes far enough. This is Spanning the State on WTMJ.
This is Libby Collins. If you've ever wondered what goes on behind the scenes at a PBS station, you're going to find out Sunday on Conversations when we talk with the Vice President and General Manager of Milwaukee PBS, Debbie Hamlet.
Got in touch with the manager for the band, and he sent me an email, and he said, I heard a rumor that you're interested in doing this concert. Is that true? And I said, absolutely, it's true. Let's talk.
WTMJ Conversations, Sunday mornings at 11 on WTMJ.
Your home's defense is crucial. Defensive failure is offensive to you. Siding Unlimited is your home's best defensive coach. Windows, roofing, decks, and of course, siding. Siding Unlimited is it. Windows? Siding Unlimited handles several great brands. They are one of only five Pella Platinum Premium installers in the whole country. The only one around here. Doors and decks, roofing, siding. Yes, 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 and yes. Nobody can beat Siding Unlimited. When you deal with Siding Unlimited, you'll get honest pricing, guaranteed. What is that? Well, no gimmicks, none of that BOGO, buy one now, get blah, 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 chin boogie. This is what it will cost you, period. Honest pricing. Bolster your home's defense with the best defensive team ever. SidingUnlimited.com.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. When it comes to painting, don't do it yourself. Call the pros at your local neighborhood Serta Pro Painters. That's what we did. Serta Pro came out, gave us choices, walked us through the process, and then when they were there, it was quick, it was easy. Our home is beautiful. Excellent workmanship all the way around. It's Serta Pro Painters. Each Serta Pro Painters business is independently owned and operated right here in Wisconsin. Schedule your free estimate online at SertaPro.com. That's Serta with a C. When choosing a painting professional, the choice is simple. Choose happy. Choose Serta Pro Painters.
Welcome back to Spanning the State. I am Kristen Bry here with Steve Scafidi, and Wisconsin political ads must now disclose if they include any AI-generated content. So candidates and political groups will have to disclose when they use artificial intelligence to generate audio or video in ads aired in Wisconsin, according to a new law that was signed in the last legislative session. So our guest is one of the co-authors, State Senator Mark Spritzer. Welcome to the show.
Thank you so much for having me.
So can you first just tell us more about the bill and what it will and will not do in practice?
So this bill won't ban AI in campaign ads, but it will require a disclosure. So if you use AI to substantially generate either audio or video in your campaign ad, you'll have to have a disclaimer that says so, so that people watching the ad understand that what they're seeing may not be reality. And that is especially important in the case of audio or video, where somebody could basically make a deep fake of their opponent that makes it look like they said or did something they never actually said or did. And we want to make sure that if people are seeing that, they understand that that may not be a real-life video. That may actually be AI-generated. But obviously, AI can also be used to create a jingle for a radio ad or create a cool animation to illustrate your views. And so, you know, we didn't want to over-regulate this, but we wanted to make sure that people understand this is a tool that could be used to deceive or just to illustrate. And we want voters to have some more information to judge what they're seeing.
So when you mentioned radio there, how would that work for radio exactly? If it would.
You would have to have a audio disclaimer as part of your radio ad. So just like you have to have the paid for by disclaimer now, you'd have to build into that the fact that the ad was generated using AI.
Just to have some fun with it. It's not going to be one of those like medical ones where it's like some guy speed reading it for like 30 seconds at the end of the ad.
It will be pretty fast. The actual disclaimer that's required for audio would say this audio content generated by AI, so that won't take terribly long in a 30-second ad.
And then what does it look like for a TV ad? Is it also an audio, or is it just like the fine print at the bottom of the TV?
It could be printed. It's required to be readable, legible, readily accessible, and it would say this video content generated by AI, or if it's audio and video, this content generated by AI. So just like you'd see at the bottom of the screen, paid for by such and such committee, you'd also see this.
So Senator Spitzer, what is the consequence if a campaign or a political group does use AI but doesn't disclose that they've used it?
So this will be regulated by the Wisconsin Ethics Commission, the same as our campaign finance laws are currently, and a violation is subject to a $1,000 fine per violation.
Was there ever any talk about trying to ban AI just overall and say, you know, we're not going to do this. We're just going to have the candidates or their campaigns or their political action committees run the ads, and we're not going to allow AI to be used? Did that come into the conversation?
There was certainly discussion of that, and I think there were two issues that are why we didn't do that. You know, number one, you've got the First Amendment, and as soon as you start banning a form of expression, there's a risk that the courts are going to come in and find that that's unconstitutional. So we wanted to get something in place that, you know, we could pass through a bipartisan legislative session and have the governor sign, that everybody could agree on, and that wasn't just going to get struck down in court. And then number two, we know that AI is a tool. It's a tool that is probably going to get used pretty extensively in this fall's election. But it's a tool that can be used for good or bad. It's a tool that can be used to present truth or to present deception. And so to either try to come in and draw that line legislatively or to outright ban it would feel like an overreaction to stifle a new technology that we don't even fully understand how it's going to play out. And so we wanted to start with disclosure so that people who are watching can understand what they're seeing, what they're hearing, and then if we go through this election cycle and it's clear that that wasn't enough, let's come back and have those additional conversations next session.
So I feel like it's pretty easy for any of us, especially living in Wisconsin, where we're constantly under lots and lots of campaign ads that are just unwavering throughout an election year. But so it's easy to me to think of where this can go wrong. Like you said, deep fakes, having candidates say things that they didn't actually say. What are some of the use cases of where it's a good thing that AI could be used for?
You know, I think more and more campaigns are having the ability to generate their own images, their own audio, their own video, without having to necessarily pay professionals to do that. And AI can be helpful with that. And so for a small campaign to have tools to get their message in front of voters and to have AI be a tool that they can use as part of that, I think that's great. I think we're seeing people use AI in a lot of different parts of their life to do anything from helping to manage their schedule to creating graphics that they might want to use for something. And so, you know, this is the thing where I want campaigns to get their message out. What I don't want them to do is deceive people into thinking that they're watching, you know, video that is something that didn't actually happen.
How widespread do you think the use of AI in some of these ads is going to be? I would think in the presidential race it would be big.
I think it will be. I think a lot of it will also be incidental, and that's why our new law specifically requires that something be substantially generated by AI in order to have the disclaimer. So we're seeing Facebook navigate this right now. Facebook is requiring that you check a box if you're running an ad that is primarily AI generated, and they specifically define that, you know, what is an example of not primarily or not substantially AI? And, you know, it's the kinds of things we've done all along, touching up somebody's appearance, you know, smoothing out some glitches in the audio, that kind of thing. And so, I think we're going to see AI working in the background as a tool, but in terms of advertising that is primarily AI generated, I do think we'll see that also.
So if we have some guy says he's running for state senate and he looks like Tom Cruise, probably not Tom Cruise.
Probably not.
All right, well, final question. Take away bipartisanship, take away what you think could pass, but for you, State Senator Mark Spitzer, if you had to change a different thing about campaign ads, what would you change?
I mean, I would, if I could wave a magic wand, you know, I'd have them be truthful. You know,
there you go. Where's my bell? That's exactly what I would have said.
You can't lie. All right.
You know, if your opponent did something you don't agree with, let's talk about it, but at least tell the truth.
At least tell the truth. Well, we really appreciate your time. State Senator Mark Spritzer, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thanks for having me.
That's a good question, though. When we come back, besides telling the truth, Steve, think about your answer of what if you had a magic wand and you got to change something about how campaign ads run during election years, what would it be? And if you at home want to let us know what you would change, 855-616-1620, the WTMJ talk and text line. This is Spanning the State.
The very front of the front office is exclusively on Wisconsin's Morning News.
We're focused on winning today, and that's where our head is.
Brewers Senior Vice President and General Manager Matt Arnold is our Brewers 360 guest.
Have you ever played Immaculate Grid? Let's try it. I've never played this game with a general manager, so I figure we can do this in 9 guesses.
Every Thursday at 7:45.
Oh, I don't know, buddy. I'm not sure. I need a little more coffee for this.
Presented by Holiday Automotive and Outdoor Living Unlimited.
That'll be fun. All right. Can't wait.
The most common form of treatment for the arthritic joints is normally cortisone injections and gel shots and over-the-counter medications. And most patients have tried all of that and are still in pain.
Every day, Dr. Aaron Wolkoff, a QC Kinetics medical director, meets patients who have exhausted every method to get relief. They've been told surgery is their only option.
They want to stay away from that path, and they come to us almost as the last hope. So we're using our own body's properties to help manage pain, to help slow arthritis down, keep the patients active with no downtime, and get them back to what they enjoy doing. I mean, I love what I do.
QC Kinetics regenerative treatments from our board-certified providers help heal and restore aching joints. No surgery, harmful drugs, or downtime. Call for your free consultation today.
Call QC Kinetics, 414-285-3474. That's 414-285-3474. 414-285-3474.
Listen to The Fix-It Show this Saturday morning in the 7 o'clock hour with special guest Chris Mancuso from Accurate Basement Repair. Chris will discuss and answer questions about basement problems and solutions. Accurate Basement Repair serves all of southeastern Wisconsin with comprehensive, cost-effective basement repairs, including foundation restoration and waterproofing. Check them out online at AccurateBasementRepair.com and listen to The Fix-It Show this Saturday starting at 7 a.m. with Accurate Basement Repair's Chris Mancuso.
St. Vincent de Paul Milwaukee has expanded into our new 76th and Bradley Road location, where thrifters will find hundreds of bargains on everything, from clothing to furniture, electronics, home goods, and more. Our inventory is always changing, and new deals pop up every day. We're accepting donations, too, at our convenient drive-through donation area. Help us help others. St. Vincent de Paul at 76th and Bradley Road in Milwaukee is now open.
Ooh, you're gonna love it, St. Vincent de Paul.
Kaiser Chevrolet has slam dunk lease deals this month. Score big on a 24 Trailblazer or a 24 Equinox with affordable leases starting at under $250 a month. Yes, under $250 a month. Plus, we will be awarding our MVPs with our exclusive Safe and Sound program, which is included on each vehicle sale. See all details at HeiserChevrolet.com. At Heiser, today's your day.
See dealer for complete details. Tax, title, license, and $399 service fees extra. Ends March 31st.
If you had a magic wand and you could change a rule or create a rule about campaign ads, what would it be? WTMJ talk and text line 855-616-1620. Steve, what would yours be?
I like this idea. I talked about this years ago on my show, on my old show. You can only talk about yourself in your ad.
I like that.
Tell your story. Tell us what you're going to do. So many of these ads now are like just going after the other side, the other candidates, linking them to, you know, like mass murderers and all the other crazy. It's like it has no relation to what we really need elected officials to actually do on the job.
And I would say the most powerful commercial I've seen for Eric Hovde since he launched his campaign is the one where his wife's talking about him.
Sharon, yeah.
That's a great commercial. And it's exactly that, right? Just talking about who he is as a candidate. That's a good one. Mine, this came out of last year's Wisconsin Supreme Court race. For some of these ads, putting a disclaimer on it that it's going to be super violent. The amount of times we were watching a Packers game and you have kids watching the game with you, and then all of a sudden an ad comes on that's talking about sexual assault or a head in an oven and just like really violent things that's just allowed to air because they bought the time, they bought the ad space, and the average listener is like, oh wow, that was a lot, and just trying to change the channel quickly from in the radio with your crib in the back of the car.
Well, I mean, here's the reality though, we can't edit the commercials.
Oh yeah, I'm not saying neither it's the media.
Yeah, it's just that's the way, it's free speech,
and that's why it would be my magic wand would say
NC-17
give you a chance to change the channel.
How about this? The texter makes this point. I agree with him. Limit the number of ads.
Oh, yeah.
I don't know, a couple a day, you know, a certain time period maybe. I don't know.
Like for each commercial break? Is that is that how many? Who would that be? Would that be on the media companies that they can only run so many political ads per commercial break?
I would think so. I mean, that's
a good one. I
never
like
that one. Never been thought of in that way, probably.
I also like it. We're one of the few countries where there is no limits on when you can start running ads.
No. It's basically all the time.
I think in Canada, it's 6 weeks.
Yeah,
it's like
I think
6 weeks before the election actually happens.
Our reality is we never stop campaigning.
Yeah.
So even when we're not in a cycle, whether it's Senate or state races or the presidential race, we're still having ads about other issues, whether it's crime, border policy. They always run. And depending on what networks you watch.
I don't know if they always run.
They're always running.
In 2023, after the Supreme Court race was over, I don't think we had were you watching enough local channels saying there was...
There was always something.
Really?
Are you going to make me do the homework on this?
I mean, you don't have to. But I'm just saying, I don't remember as many political ads in the second half of 2023.
I'd have to look through the logbooks of all the networks and all the local stations. But if that's what's required, that's what I'll do as a co-host of this show. Spanning the state.
Spanning the state. 262 says, not have them at all.
Right? Now, I will tell you that I don't watch any of them at all.
Do you change the channel when they come on?
I will change the channel, I will walk away or mute. I don't watch or listen to any of them because I think they're all stupid.
So you just do your own research.
It's what I talk about every day. So
that's
really,
true.
What's,
you're in a different position than most people.
Yeah.
Another 262 numbers texting in. Keep ads truthful, factual, and positive. Stop the negativity. There is enough negativity already in the news. I agree with that.
Here's a controversial take. No facial hair whatsoever. Putting it out there.
Just put it out there.
Mm-hmm.
You're anti-facial hair.
I'm not saying
what a beard. Is it specifically
nothing.
The mustache?
Mustache or beard? None.
Nope. Why? You just a traditional, like a clean-shaven man?
I don't think it's helpful in a campaign.
What do you mean?
It's people look at that in a different way. Clean-shaven is the way to go.
See, I think this is a totally... We only have a couple seconds before we have to kick it to ABC. Some men hide behind their beard. So maybe I do agree with you. Mm-hmm. All right, ABC News and local headlines are next.
ABC News, I'm Michelle Franzen. A U.S. official tells ABC News Israel's prime minister has agreed to reschedule his delegation's visit to the White House to discuss Israel's military plans in Rafah. That's the last refuge for Palestinians. UNICEF's James Elder says Gaza is facing a dire situation and famine. ABC's Britt Clinett has more.
Elder describes how parents are standing over their desperately starved children while there is a crossing 10 or 15 minutes away. It really was a very grim picture that he painted for the children of Gaza, so they just don't know where they're going to wake up the next day.
In Baltimore, recovery efforts continuing for six construction workers presumed dead following yesterday's bridge collapse. The cargo ship that slammed into the bridge remains in the water with mangled metal jutting out. Too dangerous, authorities say, for divers to go in today. And for the first time since December, a winning ticket drawn for Mega Millions. That ticket sold in a New Jersey ShopRite. No word yet on who won. This is ABC News.
Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Time is 1:31. A child struck by a stray bullet on Milwaukee's north side. The parents of the six-year-old tell TMJ4 News the child was playing video games in the living room when a bullet came through the side of the house at 38th and Villard. The child should be discharged from the hospital later today. The investigation is ongoing. Milwaukee's North Point parking lot closed until May for reconstruction. The lot serves Bradford Beach, the North Point concession stand, also known as Moosa's, and the lakefront. The parking lot and shoreline experienced damage over time from high Lake Michigan water levels and severe storms. And the Milwaukee County Zoo breaks ground on a renovated habitat for the zoo's 15 Humboldt penguins. Renovations include replacing an outdated filtration system and improving visitor access to the exhibit. Humboldt penguins are a globally threatened species. Time for news about your money in the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. All the indices in the green today, with the Dow currently up 323 points at 39,608, S&P 500 up about 25 points at 5227, and the NASDAQ also up today about 32 points at 16,347. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Check out annexwealthmanagement.com. Click on the Get Started button today. Now time for a look at your roads with a WTMJ Johnson & Sons Paving Time Saver traffic update. We've got slight delays if you're westbound on 894 Mitchell to Hale. Normally about a 6-minute ride. It's going to run you 8. Typical delays, 43 southbound Brown Deer to downtown through the construction zone. That'll cost you about 3 minutes today. A 14-minute ride southbound on 43. Otherwise, standard travel times across the system today. Decreasing clouds, cool and breezy today with a high of 41, mostly clear and chilly, overnight low of 25. The sun returns on Thursday with a high of 45 degrees. It's currently 34 in Madison, 31 in Green Bay, 33 in Waukesha, and 35 at the Avenue. I'm Greg Matzik, Siding Unlimited. WTMJ News Time is 1:33.
Can a local bank provide all the big bank services with the friendliness of a small-town neighbor? Waterstone Bank has been doing it for more than a century. This is your Waterstone Bank, and we're invested in the community, supporting education, women's and youth programs, and honoring our brave veterans and frontline heroes. We're at the heart of it all. Welcome to your Waterstone Bank.
Welcome back, Susan. How can I help you today?
Learn more at WSBOnline.com. That's WSBOnline.com. Member FDIC.
For over a century, local broadcasting has evolved with the needs of the community. We move past the stigmas of opinion journalism and bring the most relevant news online, on air, and on the go. You have trusted us with your news, sports, weather, and entertainment. Trust us to keep moving with you. Text radio to 52886 and tell Congress local broadcasting is here to stay.
Hey, moms, dads, and grandparents, it's spring break. With no school this week, you need an outing. Treat your kids and grandkids to the amazing Mineshaft Restaurant in Hartford, the area's most affordable, family-friendly restaurant and entertainment center. The Mineshaft has a $2 million game room with over 140 interactive games, including the most popular like Typhoon, Avengers, Ticket Ring Games, Coin Pushers, and the easiest games for your little ones. Your kids will love the Mineshaft, especially your teenagers. The kids' menu starts at just $3.99 every day, and the pizza is great. With no school this week, take your kids for hours of safe and super affordable fun to the Mineshaft in their huge game room. Grandparents, take your grandkids to the Mineshaft this week. They'll love you more than ever. The Mineshaft is in beautiful downtown Hartford. Game room opens at 10 a.m. Mineshaft Restaurant.
Our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle of our street. Our house in the middle.
Welcome back to Spanning the State. I am Kristen Bry. He is Steve Scafidi. And twice in a week. You were here with me on Monday.
Well, you know, you got the cards and letters coming in like that. You're gonna have another visit at some point. I can make it three if you want.
Well, yes, we're either going to have a show because there's a lot of rain in
New York. Yeah, 85% chance
tomorrow. So we're waiting to hear as far as if I'm not going to have a show tomorrow or I'm not going to have a show on Friday because of the Brewers.
That's the crazy thing about having the afternoon show. Mm-hmm. You never really know unless they have a dome, and they don't have a dome.
They do not have a dome.
Yeah.
So we will keep you posted on whether or not there's a Brewers game tomorrow.
Would you put a dome over your house if it was possible? I would.
What does that mean?
Completely cover my house and yard with a dome so I could climate control the whole thing year-round. I would totally do that if it was affordable.
Sure. Okay.
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. So
that's the future, isn't it?
Is it?
I think so.
So basically, you're saying if you could afford it, you would spend the money.
Yes.
I'd be like, who wouldn't do that, though?
I don't know. Some people want it to rain and snow. Remember, I got in all this trouble for saying I didn't want any more snow, and people get all angry with me because they apparently wanted snow. You could control your environment. And then you take the money you spend on heating and cooling your house, heating and cooling the dome.
You've thought about this.
I have thought about it.
Well, I don't know how much more that would put a home's value up, because already, this is, here's the segue.
Crazy.
Into the number of houses and like the price of housing has skyrocketed in comparison to how wages are increasing.
And isn't the cost of homes, price of homes doubled in 5 years or something like that? It's nuts.
Yeah. So Wisconsin Policy Forum report showed that since 2017, home prices in Wisconsin have risen much faster than incomes, making buying a home a more daunting endeavor. And this is not just Milwaukee and Madison. This is across the state. And I think this is interesting because in comparison to what we were talking about on Monday with Dave Spano, where there is more and more debt delinquency. Mm-hmm. And one of the things Dave's reinforced is that a lot of people are putting things that they, like the necessities instead of just the wants, on credit cards. And then that is stacking up. And I wonder how much this is tied to things getting more expensive, whether it be housing, whether it be consumer goods, but incomes not rising nearly as quickly.
No, when you talk about inflation, double-digit inflation, your income doesn't typically go up that much in a wage period, which is usually a year for most people.
Because what year did you buy your house?
1993. And it's worth about three and a half times or more, three to four times what I paid for
it. She paid for it then. And I wonder how much that is tied up to the wealth that we were talking about on Monday with the boomers having so much wealth. Is the fact that you guys mostly bought your house during a time when the ratio of housing prices to income was much smaller.
Yes.
And now that housing has gone way up. And so what you're going to be able to sell your house for,
yes,
is huge.
The problem with doing that is you have to buy a house to move into once you sell your house, or an apartment.
But don't you think most boomers, that was because it was, yeah, so much more accessible?
Sure. Same problem with the same issue with the generation before us. Folks could get into a house in the early 60s for like 15 grand. It's the same thing. Every generation has that. I would argue boomers are just smarter, but we can have that conversation on a different day.
All right. When we come back, we're going to be talking to the author of the Wisconsin Policy Forum report that showed the home in prices in Wisconsin rising as fast as they have. Stay with us. This is Spanning the State.
Your nose is for breathing. Your mouth is for eating. And if you're breathing through your mouth, it's not because your body wants to. It's because it has to, because your nose isn't working properly. And although you've lived like this, it's no way to live, and it's having a significant impact on your life. I know you know this, and I know that taking action isn't always convenient. But at Advent, we've done all we can to make changing your life for the better as easy as possible. I'm Dr. Madan Kandula. With tens of thousands of our patients, a thorough breathing triangle evaluation, along with a simple 20-minute in-office procedure called balloon sinuplasty, has opened their nasal passages, allowing them to breathe freely through their nose for good. And there's a good chance this procedure can do the same for you. We'll help you breathe through your nose again, and it will change your life.
Go to AdventNose.com to schedule your appointment, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better.
I'm going to say it again. Our mission is to protect and uphold our reputation. And what that means is wherever we go, we make it better for those in need of our services and the great people we have working with us. Our reputation matters. Over the years, we've cut our losses with a handful of people that just didn't live our values as much as we'd like. And a lot of them, if not all of them, still work in the industry today. I say this because I want you to know when you work with Semper Fi, character counts. It's why you can count on the industry's hands-down best lifetime workmanship warranty that now includes free annual inspections. And it's why we always have one project manager per job, which is absolutely not the industry standard. When you're paying for a brand new roof to go on what's likely the biggest investment you have, you want it done right, and you want to be able to count on the people doing it. This is Brad Youngluth with Semper Fi Roofing and Exteriors, your local, veteran-owned and operated exterior remodeling company.
We keep you safe, warm, and dry, Semper Fi.
Find furniture for life from Ken Michaels Furniture in Brookfield, Greenfield, or downtown Milwaukee.
With each breath, allergens, germs, and viruses get trapped in your nose. Now there's a simple, easy, and effective way to clean your nose and protect your health. It's called Navage. N-A-V-A-G-E. Available at Navage.com.
AccuNet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button.
One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Well, I mentioned it, and then it happened. It was like calling Rumpelstiltskin's name. So, while we were at break, it has been posted that Brewers are postponed for tomorrow. They will play on Friday, so we will be here tomorrow. Steve will not be here, though. I'm taking the afternoon off.
Yeah, I'm probably, if it was nice enough, I would golf, but it's probably not going to be nice. But I can call in if you'd like.
Didn't we talk about that on Monday? Just every time you wanted to add something, just light up the phone?
I feel like that's my role, but, you know. Other people, as we saw in the text line, may disagree.
All right. So, yes. So, Brewers postponed for tomorrow. The game will be Friday. We will be here tomorrow, though. And here right now with us is Forum senior researcher Joe Pietrangelo, who is the author of a new report that shows how much home prices have outpaced incomes in Wisconsin over the last 5 years. Welcome to the show, Joe.
Hi. Thanks for having me.
So, why does the ratio between the price of homes and income matter? Why should we care about this?
Well, it matters because it reflects the relative affordability of the housing market. As a general rule, many real estate agents say that home buyers can afford roughly 2.5 times their annual income on a home, but many households spend more than that. And because we've been seeing prices rising, it's becoming a more common problem throughout the state.
Not to play contrarian, but is perhaps some of the problem, small part, large part, that people buy homes, they don't need all that space, but they just want to have a bigger home? Is that part of this?
I mean, it could be. I would say our analysis didn't get into the details to that extent. Many households do spend more than they can afford because they want that more valuable home. But I think what we're seeing here with the overall trends is notable because it's just making the market more challenging for just the general home buyer that's trying to buy a home that they could afford otherwise.
And so what does the analysis show as far as what you guys got into in the report?
Yeah, so basically between 2017 and 2022, we found that in Wisconsin, the median home sales price went up by about 53%. And at the same time, incomes went up by only about 20%. So that a huge difference there. And the median price of homes went up to about $265,000 in 2022, which was about 3.7 times higher than the state's median household income. And so that was the highest ratio we've seen in data. We have data back to 2007. That's the highest ratio we've seen during that period.
So who's it impacting the most? Who's taking the biggest hit here?
So we found that we also looked at this by county. We found that, you know, different counties throughout the state have different ratios, meaning it's more difficult for that median household to afford to buy a home. Dane County really stood out, for example. Their housing market is very expensive. The median home there sold for $385,000 in 2022 and went up over $400,000 in 2023. We found several counties up in northern Wisconsin that had very high ratios, but that may be impacted by the vacation homes that are concentrated in some of those communities. But we also looked at it from a generally, it's affecting first-time homebuyers. Of course, people trying to get in the market for the first time would be facing a bigger challenge now than in past years. It also affects certain communities to a greater extent. We found, for example, that the median priced home was 6.8 times the median income for Black households. So it's affecting different communities in different ways as well.
So what's causing this? Is it a combination of not building enough houses? Is it people buying second homes? Like, what is the culmination of different external factors?
I think that the, you know, it's multiple factors. One of the biggest factors is us not keeping up with the pace of growth in terms of new households being added to the state. We're not building enough housing to keep up with that new growth. So we looked at changes in households, the number of households in Wisconsin since 2010, and there's been an increase of over 211,000 new households in the state, and we've only permitted about 145,000 new housing units during that time. So that leaves a 67,000 unit gap, which, you know, reduces vacancy rates and it increases competition for the housing that we do have, and that helps to raise prices. So that's one big factor. And then the pandemic sort of exacerbated that, because many people wanted to buy homes during that time, and then people who owned homes didn't necessarily want to sell and move at that time. So that kind of added pressure to what was already a problem of us not keeping up with demand.
One of the things that gets talked about a lot is affordable housing. I know as a former elected, we always were trying to figure out ways to make that formula work. I know the governor and the legislature have worked on some bipartisan measures to improve this situation. What do you know about that?
The state passed several new programs, or basically created several new programs, and the state budget directed $525 million to those programs. So these are programs that WEDA, the state's housing authority, is administering, and they provide zero or low interest loans to help make affordable housing, workforce housing, senior housing developments more feasible. And so that's certainly significant. It's pretty early to be able to judge the impact of those programs. They just started to actually award projects. There were, I believe, three projects only so far that received the first awards through those programs. So we need to kind of give those more time to really see what the impact will be. Local governments are also doing things. So another factor in this is how zoning relates to the housing that is built. And the city of Milwaukee and Madison are both, for example, working on changes to their zoning codes designed to allow more types of housing and more housing to be built in more places as a way of trying to get at this supply issue and try to, you know, help bring prices down.
Bring prices down. Well, as I bought my house, so I don't necessarily want the price to come down, which I'm sure other homeowners are buying. But for the average first time, yes, stabilize. That is a better, maybe that's a better term for it. Well, Joe Pietrangelo, thank you for joining us. Super interesting stuff.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for having us.
Setting Unlimited News Time 150. This is Spanning the State.
Woo! Hey, this is Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Ortman on ESPN Wisconsin. People can't stop screaming about the Screamin' Sicilian Frozen Pizza, and no wonder, there's plenty to scream about, like the buttery stone-fired crust, secret recipe tomato sauce, mounds of whole milk mozzarella, and tons of premium toppings. Find Screamin' Sicilian in your local grocer's freezer and find out for yourself why Sports called Screamin' Sicilian's Holy Pepperoni Frozen Pizza the best of the best. Screamin' Sicilian, taste what all the screaming is about.
At Blaine's Farm and Fleet, we get you outdoors because we get you. Whether you're ready to hit the road, tackle the yard, or start a new project, we get you the right products at the right prices. Like 36-pound bags of Estate Crabgrass Preventer with lawn fertilizer, $32.99. Get organized with $30 off DeWalt 4-foot 3-tier industrial shelving. And break up rust or corrosion with Blaster Penetrating Catalyst, $32.99 a gallon. We get you outdoors because we get you at Blaine's Farm and Fleet.
When the centurion who stood facing him saw how he breathed his last, he said, "Truly, this man was the Son of God." Hello, this is Archbishop Lestecky. Imagine how much God loved us to die for us. But he would not allow his son to be forgotten in the tomb. Instead, God the Father's love raised him up and offered hope to all of us who believe in him. The Eucharist is the sacrificial act which joins us to his love. A blessed Easter to all. Join us at Mass.
Annex Wealth Management, investment, retirement, tax, and estate planning from a fee-only fiduciary. Forget commission sales pitches and financial products you don't need. Know the difference. Annex provides elite, comprehensive financial planning customized to who you are and what you need. AnnexWealth.com.
There are surgeons lining up to be the one to do your joint replacement. But my advice? Exhaust all your options and put off joint replacement as long as you can. Make it your very last resort. Because life after joint replacement isn't always what it's cracked up to be. As high as 30% of patients who have undergone joint replacement surgery report unsatisfactory results. And the cost, even with insurance, can be extraordinary. At Rejuvenix, we'll help ease your pain and improve your mobility with FDA-approved pharmacological treatments that precisely target where your pain lives. And by easing your pain and inflammation, we'll help you live a better life. And because we're in-network with most major insurance plans, your out-of-pocket expense could be very affordable, or nothing at all. This is Richard Salinas, registered nurse with Rejuvenix Arthritis Clinics, where we can alleviate your pain and rejuvenate your life.
Rejuvenix. Alleviate your pain, rejuvenate your life.
Go to Rejuvenix.com to request your appointment.
Get the help you need Saturday morning with How To Radio. At 7, it's the WTMJ Fix-It Show with David Nason, featuring this week's guest, Accurate Basement Repair. At 9, plan your dream vacation with the Fox World Travel Show. And at 10, get financial guidance during Money Talk. Contact Annex Wealth Management for an unbiased review of your investments at annexwealth.com. How To Radio, Saturday mornings on WTMJ.
Spanning the states. That's weird beats me saying that because I've never said that before.
You said it in the previous segment.
I did?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. I yelled it out at the end. But it's your show.
It is my show.
Kristen Bry, of course. Steve Scafidi from the Political Power Hour. 9 to 10, Monday through Friday on WTMJ.
What do you have tomorrow?
Legal hour.
Who you got?
Mary Kuhnmensch and I believe Matt O'Neill, I think. Former judge and local attorney.
Do you have a favorite day now?
It's interesting. Journalist Monday, they're all good. Public Safety Wednesday, I've got Advocacy on Tuesday, Legal Thursday, Strategists on Friday from both sides. They're all good.
They are all good. That's why I asked if you have a favorite.
No, you can't. It's like picking a favorite child. Who does that?
I bet you do have a favorite child.
My daughter. One of my daughters will say I do. Judy.
I think my brother thinks I'm the favorite as well.
Yeah, I think that's normal.
Yeah.
Right?
I'm also much more well-behaved than he is. I'm a much more agreeable person than he is.
Yeah, like now or... yeah,
throughout life, in general.
I don't think that's true. All right, so on this home thing, you and I were chatting during the break.
Yes.
I make the argument that you go back a ways. Again, I'm a boomer, as you like to point out frequently on your program.
You brought it up.
We used to move into homes, and there's still some of this if you buy old house stock, where your starter home is like 1,500 square feet. Nobody's building 1,500 square foot new houses. Perhaps that's a segment of the industry that's ripe for consideration.
But it's also the fact that
starter home neighborhood.
Same thing in the rental side, right?
Right.
If you look at all of the development of new apartment complexes in Milwaukee, they're all not affordable necessarily for the average young person. Right? They're $1,500, $2,000 in rent, and so the developers who are trying to make a profit, obviously, off of what they're building.
Sure.
And so I think I agree with you in that what's getting built as far as new homes for which income level, and the same thing of what apartments are becoming available for what in which income level.
I think we have to work harder, everyone, consumers, people who provide housing, build housing, local leaders, and providing that segment of this industry. Give them some oxygen, give them some resources, give them some money, give them some room to build neighborhoods like that, starter home neighborhoods. I think they'd be fascinating places to live.
Because you think about it, so many of the neighborhoods around Milwaukee, were Wauwatosa, or, you know, then you look at Bayview or even Shorewood, as far as it was city lots.
Yeah.
The houses small. Are not, the houses are, I think the style of the houses are super cute, but like the lots are smaller, the houses are smaller, and it was built in a time when it was very encouraged for everyone as much as possible to be buying a house.
Yes. That was the thing you did.
That was the thing
and
you
it's
did.
Not the thing you do now. And, you know, maybe it's just generational. People have different wants. We also would have laughed out loud over and over again if somebody would have told me they were spending $8 on a cup of coffee. But here we are.
I don't spend $8 on a cup of coffee.
Some people do, though.
I don't buy avocado toast.
I don't even like avocado toast.
Do you like avocados?
Yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm.
All right. Coming up after the news, big news yesterday that I feel like kind of flew under the radar, but Wisconsin Utilities pledged to use union labor for all of their clean energy construction. So we're going to talk about that when we come back. And at the second half of the hour, potato or egg? Which one will you be dying for Easter this weekend? This is Spanning the State.
WTMJ, W277CV, and WKTI HD2 Milwaukee from the Annex Wealth Management Studios. This is News Radio WTMJ, a Good Karma brand station.
Remember the ice storm of 76? We cooked frozen pizza with matchsticks. We used homemade aluminum foil solar panels to stay warm. And we were without power for 9 months. Or was it 9 days? I don't know. I was 5 years old, so my memory's a little fuzzy. Probably from all the frostbite. The point is, a prolonged period without power is no picnic. Fortunately, technology has improved significantly since 76. Today, we have backup emergency generators to keep power powering and furnaces furnacing when the weather gets wild. Call Mr. Holland's Home Services to schedule the installation of a brand new high-efficiency gas furnace and AC or generator combo for a whole lot less than you'd typically pay. Plus, we make it easy to pay with up to 24 months interest-free financing with approved credit. 866-992-1717. Or visit MrHollandsHomeServices.com. If you're haunted by the spirit of 76, we can help.
I love the Fox and Hounds. WTMJ's John Merck here. The historic restaurant was recently voted one of the top supper clubs in the area. First opened in 1933, it's been serving fabulous dinners for almost 90 years in their rustic timber structure. When you buy one dinner, your second dinner is free 7 days a week. Buy one, get one free. Every Wednesday, when you buy one world-class prime rib dinner, your second prime rib dinner is free. Order any dinner on the menu. Your second one is free. Made from scratch desserts, buy one, get one free. Add a Manhattan, an old-fashioned, or choose from over 100 wines to accent your dinner. The Fox and Hounds is family-owned and one of the most unique and affordable supper clubs in Wisconsin. Your second dinner is always free. Just off Highway 167, 2 miles east and in the shadows of the beautiful Holy Hill Shrine. As the seasons begin to change, the drive is just beautiful. Gotta check it out. Enjoy a free prime rib dinner tonight or any entree. Tables are still open. Reserve at foxandhoundsrestaurant.com. It'll lift your spirits. It's the famous Fox and Hounds.
Wait now or wait a little longer. You may have just increased your lifetime income by tens of thousands of dollars. That's how Social Security can work for you. The longer you wait, the more money you may get. Deciding when to start taking your Social Security benefits is one of the most important retirement decisions you'll make. Our team at Drake & Associates can show you the options and help make the right decision for your situation. You spent decades paying in. Optimize what comes out. Drake & Associates can help you squeeze every penny out of your Social Security benefits. Claim your free Retirement Ready Toolkit that has guides on Social Security. To get our complimentary toolkit, call or text SS to 414-409-9982. That's calling or texting SS to 414-409-9982.
Investment advisory services provided by Drake & Associates, LLC, an SEC registered investment advisor. Insurance products are offered through a separate company, Loft Financial Advisory Group, LLC, a Wisconsin insurance agency. Clients are under no obligation to purchase any recommended insurance products.
Your trusted and relevant source for news, sports, traffic, and weather. We are Wisconsin's radio station, News Radio 620, WTMJ, Milwaukee.
At 2:01, it is 42 degrees, partly cloudy skies throughout the afternoon. Cooler, breezy today, high about 42. Overnight tonight, mostly clear skies, chilly, low 25. Tomorrow, mostly sunny, a high of 45 degrees. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Mike Spaulding. Well, there won't be baseball at least not tomorrow. The Brewers officially announcing that their opening day game against the New York Mets in New York has been postponed due to adverse weather on the East Coast. First pitch now for Brewers and Mets will be on Friday at 12:40. Our coverage on WDTMJ gets underway at 12:05. Here at home, a federal lawsuit accusing a Milwaukee public school principal of abusing a first grader for having gay parents. Milwaukee French Immersion School former assistant principal Kasongo Kambula allegedly told the students that his parents would, quote, burn in hell, and at one point threatened to kill the student if he told anybody about that abuse. The criminal complaint says Kambula would lock the student in a dark room for hours and failed to protect him from bullies. That student is now in psychiatric treatment for trauma and anxiety. A child struck by a stray bullet on Milwaukee's north side. Parents of the six-year-old telling our news partners at TMJ4 that the child was playing video games in the living room when a bullet entered the side of their home near 38th and Villard. Family members say that the child is expected to be discharged from the hospital later today. Milwaukee police say they continue to seek unknown suspects. Out east, more details regarding the six people who are presumed dead after the Francis Scott Key Bridge in Baltimore collapsed overnight last night. CBS's Nicole Skanga. The federal investigators have recovered the voyage data recorder from that cargo ship. Waukesha County is considering a half-cent sales tax to keep funding big-ticket items like the sheriff's department. County Executive Paul Farrow telling Wisconsin's Afternoon News on Tuesday the consideration is not because of Milwaukee County's sales tax increase. Farrow going on to say that Ozaukee County is the only one in Wisconsin with a lower tax rate than Waukesha County. And some media news in Milwaukee. Longtime editor-in-chief of the Milwaukee Business Journal, Mark Cass, is scheduled to leave the paper. He'll be leaving in mid-April to join Milwaukee sports media firm Team Lammy as a senior executive. Cass also becomes the executive director of the Wisconsin Athletic Hall of Fame. The Business Journal says the search for a successor will begin immediately. Sports, traffic, and weather are next. Citing Unlimited, WTMJ News Times 204.
At Fisher Investments, we may seem like other money managers, but we're different.
What makes you so different than the rest of us?
We ensure clients receive unparalleled service at every step of the relationship.
Tell me more.
Our investment counselors focus on service over sales, prioritizing clients' needs.
How do you make money?
We don't sell any commission-based products. We have a simple management fee based on the value of our clients' portfolio. So we do better when our clients do better.
What about client portfolios?
We get to know each client, their finances, family, health, lifestyle, and more. And then we tailor a portfolio based on their specific goals and needs.
Your clients really come first then, huh?
Yes, we make them a top priority. Our goal is helping them achieve a comfortable retirement.
Wow, maybe we are different.
At Fisher Investments, we're clearly different. Learn more at fisherinvestments.com.
Investing in securities involves the risk of loss.
If affordable home decor is what you've been looking for, look no further, because we're happy to show you just how easily glass can turn up the wow value of your home. Take those old kitchen cabinet doors. You pull the cabinet doors off their hinges, mill out the center, and we'll replace it with glass. It could have a design, or we could use plain glass for a simple metro look. We can design any look you're going for, from traditional to prairie, beveled glass, even custom designs. And it doesn't stop there. Entry glass, transoms, bath mirrors, rec room mirrors. How about a rec room mirror with your personalized sports design sandblasted right on? That could be a pretty cool look. All it takes is a little outside-of-the-box thinking, and we'll help you get there. This is Stacy Sinks with Less's Glass Service. If it's a new glass shower door, fogged or broken insulated glass replacement, or affordable glass and mirror home decor that you've been looking for, you just can't pass on Less's Glass. Less's Glass Service, serving all of southeastern Wisconsin. Find us at lessglassservice.com.
Time for a WTMJ sports update from the Gruber Law Office's One Call, That's All Sports Desk. Opening day will be a day late. The Brewers and Mets will not be opening up the MLB season tomorrow afternoon as expected. The Brewers confirming that game has been postponed to Friday. This is due to some rain in New York. That makeup game will take place Friday afternoon. Our network coverage gets underway at 12:05, first pitch at 12:40. That game and every game during the Brewers season can be heard right here on WTMJ. The Crew's home opener, that'll be next Tuesday, April 2nd. In the NFL, There'll be two games played on Christmas Day this season. It's odd because December 25th falls on a Wednesday. And according to Packers president Mark Murphy, the team should find out in the next several days if they'll in fact be opening up the regular season against the Eagles in Brazil. Taking a look at your roads and your Johnson & Sons paving, time saver traffic. Things are looking pretty good out on the system right now. It does look like there is at least a disabled vehicle out near State Fair Park heading westbound on I-94. You'll be slowing down right around the stadium interchange, but no major delays, just something to take note as you head through the area. Your WTMJ five-day forecast, mostly clear skies throughout the remainder of the afternoon. Breezy and chilly overnight tonight, a low 25. Tomorrow, sunny skies, a high 45 degrees. Friday, partly cloudy, chance of rain late, a high 46 lakeside, 53 degrees inland. Saturday, chance of a morning rain shower or two, a high 50 degrees lakeside, 55 inland. And on Sunday, chance of a rain shower, mostly cloudy, a high of 44 degrees. Right now in Milwaukee, it's 36 degrees. I'm Mike Spaulding, Siding Unlimited, WTMJ News Times, 208.
65,498 square miles. We've got a lot to cover, so let's get to it. This is Spanning the State. Here's your host, Kristen Bry.
Welcome back to Spanning the State, the 2 o'clock hour. If you missed anything from the first hour, you can always go listen to it as a podcast on WTMJ.com. Look for Spanning the State or find us on Apple and Spotify podcasts where you can hit the subscribe button. Maybe leave us a review because we're still a new show.
Yeah, brand spanking new. What are you, a month in now?
This is week six.
Is it really? Mm-hmm. So I've done six of these?
That sounds right. Mm-hmm.
Think I'm getting better or worse?
Well, you're pretty good at this. I think you're good at this.
Let's see what the text line says, shall we?
All right, well, you may not like it. Some people are pro-union, some people are anti-union, but regardless, this, to me, is a very big deal. Wisconsin Utilities pledged to use union labor for clean energy construction. What does that mean? It means that union workers will build most of the renewable energy installations in Wisconsin, and this is under an agreement between the state's investor-owned utilities. So this is WEC Group, which is We Energy, Alliant Energy, Madison Gas and Electric, and Xcel Energy, and this is with the big, with the five labor unions. Mm-hmm. And so did you see this story yesterday?
Yeah, I mean, I told you during one of the breaks, like, utility stories are not my most exciting story because I talk about politics generally, maybe sports once in a while if I'm not talking about politics. But I understand the significance of this because, you know, we need people to make good, decent, family-sustaining, home-buying wages. That's a good thing.
Mm-hmm.
Union representation in this country is somewhere between 10 and 50%, I think. It's not a big group.
It's growing.
It's back on the upward trend after years of going down. It was much higher than that, you know, a generation ago. So this is a good news thing. Where I fall into the, you know, too much is too much, demanding that something happen like this, unionization versus non-unionization. You know what I'm saying?
Well, at least how I read. So I read about this in the Milwaukee Journal Sentinel, who wrote it up yesterday. And it seems like it's a pledge based on a negotiation that is arguing that the contractors are saving money by not using out-of-state workers and shipping projects to out-of-state workers as far as travel fees and a bunch of stuff like that. And it's keeping that money in the Wisconsin economy by hiring people who work in Wisconsin and thus will spend their money in Wisconsin.
Yeah, I love the idea of hiring Wisconsin workers,
mm-hmm.
especially for good-paying jobs. That makes complete sense. So you can make the numbers work, get people trained up to do these jobs. And here's the reality about the workforce now. They start doing this, they learn those skills, they can go on to even better careers, maybe doing something else.
Well, and that's the thing we've talked about in this show before, is the fact that college is not for everyone.
Absolutely not.
And creating apprenticeships and pathways to really good jobs that don't require you to have a liberal arts degree or, you know, business degree or whatever, but actually learn a trade. And this feels like, because these are the numbers. So there's analysis from Climate Jobs National Resource Center that said there's 95 renewable energy projects in Wisconsin that have either are currently under construction, under regulatory review, or have been announced. And so it estimates that those 95 projects are going to account for 18,000 jobs.
And you know the political side of this, right?
Well, yeah, it's the Infrastructure Act.
And, yes.
Yeah.
all of that. So, I mean, that's the reality. Look, if it, again, if it brings jobs, keeps workers here in Wisconsin, raise their families, continue that legacy years in the future, it's great news. Great news. I will not argue with that at all.
All right. Well, when we come back, we're going to talk to Dylan Gorman, who is the business manager for IBEW 965, which is an electrical worker labor union. And he'll tell us what this means for his union, what the negotiation looked like, and what this means for Wisconsin going forward. All right. This is Spanning the State.
I'm Sandy Max, host of WTMJ's What's on Tap. Weeknights at 6, you're invited to join me for conversations about culture and creativity in Wisconsin and around the world.
Well, for the first time ever, we are serving St. Patrick's Cream Puff.
Discover and rediscover music, theater, film, food, and topics that are unique to our state.
As of today, we've announced that Milwaukee Film will be taking over Operation at the Downer.
It's your hour-long escape from the ordinary. What's on Tap on WTMJ and wherever you get your podcasts.
Acunet Mortgage is an equal housing lender. NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Whether you're seeking endless sunshine, ancient landmarks, or scenic views, Fox World Travel can take you there. We are proud to partner with outstanding cruise companies, including Holland America, Princess Cruises, Celebrity, and Royal Caribbean, to bring you unbeatable rates for your next cruise. Unleash your inner adventurer and book your dream cruise by visiting foxworldtravel.com or calling us at 866-GO-FOX-GO. Enjoy the freedom of unpacking once and set sail for adventure.
Welcome back to Spanning the State. I am Kristen Bry here with Steve Scafidi. And news yesterday broke that Wisconsin utilities are pledging to use union labor for clean energy construction. And on the phone with us now is Dylan Gorman, who is the business manager for IBEW 965, which is an electrical worker union. Welcome to the show, Dylan.
Hi there. Thanks for having me.
Yeah, of course. So what does yesterday's announcement mean? Put it in context for us.
Yeah, it was a big step for us, the IBEW anyways, and utilities to really just say that, you know, as we build these projects and move towards green energy, we're going to continue to use union labor to build these projects. And it takes a big load off the union, and I think the employers too, is in the utilities, knowing and being able to plan what those projects are going to look like and what labor they're going to be able to use.
Dylan, for all the non-union members out there, I was a union when I was a younger person, and I understand what they do, what they can't do. From your perspective, what does this mean for unions, for workers, for wages going forward?
Yeah, it's interesting because, you know, there's two different pieces to this. We're talking about constructing the facilities, you know, so we're having union electricians and, you know, operating engineers, you know, whatever hands we can get to help out with these projects. But then when the projects are done, they also turn into another union job, which is kind of the aspect that I have right now. You know, for the past however many years, the electrical grid has been primarily operated by the IBEW, operated, maintained, and built by a union. And moving forward, a pledge like this sees that that's going to continue to happen. And we've seen in the past where, you know, I don't want to not pick a non-union or union, but it's just the fact that Badger Hollow, for example, in Madison, there was a project up there that they tried to build non-union, out of state. It was behind schedule. The quality of work wasn't the same. And then at the end of the day, union counterparts had to come in and fix it, and the money that was spent up to that point left our state. So whether you're in a union or not, when pledges like this are signed, dollars that come from the federal government back to Wisconsin are going to stay in Wisconsin, and that helps the economy for everybody.
Dylan, beyond what you just said as far as money staying in Wisconsin and circulating through our economy, what were the other economic reasons why the utility companies decided to make this pledge?
Because you know what you're going to get. When you hire a union to do the work, you're getting years and years of training and experience to do this, and you don't have to do it twice. We like to call it ownership. When you own something and it's yours, you take care of it, you build it with pride, just like you would at your own home. And so from a cost perspective, you know, there's the initial cost, you know, which many will look at and kind of focus on. But when you look at the long-term effect and doing the job once and making sure it's quality, it saves utilities time and money in the long run, but it also ensures that they're going to get a product that it's going to last them for a long time.
President Biden's been in the state talking about the Inflation Reduction Act, big bridge project, northern Wisconsin, northwest Wisconsin. How does that play into this story?
With Biden coming to Wisconsin?
No,
Inflation
Reduction Act.
Yeah, so the Inflation Reduction Act has a lot to do with this funding, and it really makes sure there's pieces within the Inflation Reduction Act that ensures utilities and unions are going to work together to get that funding. A piece of that puzzle is, you know, when utilities or other employers submit for that funding or that grant money, they'd like to see a letter of support from the union. You know, what is your relationship with the union and the workers in your state? How is that money going to be spent? What kind of history do you have? Up in Portage, Wisconsin, Alliant Energy, for example, is building the first of its kind in the country. It's going to be an energy dome. It's a CO2 battery. You'll have to look it up for those that are listening, but it's a really neat piece of technology that's coming from across the seas, and they're going to build it right in Wisconsin. And that funding came out of the IRA, and it came with a letter of support from our union saying that we want to do this project with the utility.
So one piece of this that I read is the big part about the apprenticeships. And so what does the workforce look like when we look at unions right now, especially so it was the building trades, electricians, laborers, carpenters, and equipment operators. What is the age gap between how many existing union members are maybe on their way towards retirement versus trying to recruit younger people to be part of those unions?
The recruitment phase is full on, and that's, I wouldn't necessarily say that's because we're going to see a lot of people leaving. We've seen them leave already. I would say in the last 5 years, we've lost a significant amount of retirement anyways and move on into that next phase of their career. But then on top of that, we've seen the work pick up. So while people have left and we've been bringing people in, we've just been seeing a lot more work come into the industry. And it's been hard to, it's been difficult to keep up with. But, you know, we've come up with agreements. You know, you see the utility labor pledge, you know, with utilities and unions working together. There's also union pledges, you know, saying that we're going to work with other unions to make sure that we have enough people to complete this project. And those are first of its kind, too. I mean, so there's a lot of partnerships going on with this. And, you know, anyone looking to get involved into a union, you can knock on any union's door and they're going to help you get where you need to be, even if it's not with their union.
I'm a big fan of following the rules. One of the things that happens when you follow the rules is safety usually results from that. Better safety, improved practices, better standards. That's a part of this as well, right?
Yeah, it's, you know, this was probably 10 years ago now, 10, 11 years ago. But when Alliant Energy, as an example, started to build these wind facilities, wind turbines, there were two options. You could have a lift assist in the turbine, which would, you know, carry the worker to the top of the turbine and help them work on it, or you could have a cheaper option and just put a stairway. It was about a $7,000 difference. Alliant Energy, through negotiation with the union, decided to go with the lift assist when a lot of the turbines around in the area weren't having that option. And really what that came down to is looking at, you know, what's a knee replacement cost? You know, what's the strain on a person's body? You know, but instead of just looking at cost, they turn and talk to labor and what do you guys think? And, you know, through discussions, we came up with a safer option. Now that's just one small piece, but you look at, you know, just the history and how dangerous this work can be. You know, throughout time, we've developed rules and procedures to keep our members safe. And they really own that. They make sure that, you know, if you're a young apprentice coming in or you're someone that's been there for 25 years, we hold each other accountable, making sure that we're all going home to our families. Just the way we came to work.
Dylan, last question before we let you go. You mentioned the dome. Is there any other, what's the most exciting project that's planned that maybe you're going to work on or not?
You know, I'm excited to see what the Energy Dome can do. It's like I said, it's the first of its kind. It's big. You know, there's some new battery technology, but it's really all exciting to me just to see where things are going to end up. But you know, one important thing for everyone to understand is with electricity, you know, and demand, you know, comes a need for it, right? So we need to make sure that whatever this new technology is, you know, it might be supplemented by something else, just because we need to make sure that we have the power that's needed for our state. And, you know, there's a lot of conversations going on, but I'm excited for all of it. I'm really excited that we're going to be a part of it and working together to accomplish it.
All right. Dylan Gorman is the business manager for IBW 965. Thanks so much for spending time with us.
Yeah, thank you.
Citing Unlimited News Time 222, this is Spanning the State.
Get inside the mind of Mark Tauscher.
I always enjoy having a podium. Like if you're giving a speech, I'll say you want a podium. Who passes on a podium?
See the world from his perspective on Wisconsin's Morning News.
Have you ever been asked a question that when they ask it, you're like, that's kind of a dumb one?
Every day at 7:50.
Yeah, we'll be pretty much.
Every
Jason
day.
Will be
it's
9 to 12 life. Pretty much every morning. Yeah.
Mark Tauscher on Wisconsin's Morning News. Presented by your Wisconsin Chevy dealer. Tele Windows and Doors of Wisconsin. And Kohler Service.
Hey, boaters!
We have the go-to marine store. And it's not just because we have all the boat parts and supplies you'll ever need, including oddball parts you thought you'd never be able to find. And it's also because we're cheaper than the other guys, too. So why shop anywhere else? This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. Boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. When you get here, you might be overwhelmed when you see so much stuff. But don't be, because our staff knows just where to find what you need. They're knowledgeable, friendly, and willing to help so that you can find everything you need to keep your boat in tip-top shape. Boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th and Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey, boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
Meet Alan, who was diagnosed with sleep apnea.
I was what they call a mouth breather, and I would breathe at night with my mouth open.
And for about 8 years, Alan struggled with a CPAP machine. And then?
And then I saw the Advent commercial, and I thought, well, what do you got to lose? This machine is miserable.
For most people, CPAP machines are miserable, but a simple breathing triangle solution from Advent can be life-changing.
And it really was, to me it was amazing, because I don't think I ever breathed that clear.
This is Dr. Bhavan Kandula. After having one of Advent's simple breathing triangle procedures, people are amazed at how freely and clearly they can breathe.
I'm happy with the procedure. I'm very glad I did it. I wish I would have done it 20 years ago. I could have avoided that machine I had to have laying next to the bed with the hose wrapped around my head.
Schedule your appointment at AdventKnows.com, because Advent knows when you breathe well, you live better. Results may vary.
Hey, WTMJ's John Merck here. Transform your bathroom like we did. It's Sidex, S-I-D-E-X, Sidex. Take out that conventional bathtub, put in a walk-in shower. That's what we did at our house. It's beautiful. It's open. It's transformed our bathroom. And right now with Sidex, you get $750 off any bathtub or shower replacement. They serve within 60 miles of Milwaukee. It's Sidex. They did the work at our house. It was quick. It was affordable, it was efficient, and our bathroom is beautiful. Go with the company we trust, Sidex. Free shower door upgrade when you mention WTMJ or John Mercier.
Cranking some Jimi Hendrix on a Wednesday afternoon, WTMJ.
Does it feel like Wednesday?
No.
I don't know what day it feels
like. I woke
like
up
right
at 3.
Now.
It feels like Friday at 4 o'clock.
Yeah. So we have someone on the text line who was commenting on the union labor and the utility companies and getting a vote as far as where unions or where the utility companies get their labor from. But one of the things he did point out, they pointed out, I don't know if it's a woman or a man, is that you don't have a choice in utilities. And that is something that is always,
yeah,
I don't know if bugged me is the right word, but it's just in our capitalist free market society, when it comes to utilities, it is so strange to me that we're like, well, this is what you got.
It's not the same everywhere. I mean, I was talking to you in a break about like Texas has like a ton of different energy providers. It's a train wreck.
I know. So is this the best system that we
have dependable energy here? I'm a big We Energies guy.
You are a big We
Energies guy. Oh, yeah.
So you're never up in arms when you hear the trees fall and the lines are down and someone has no energy or no electricity for 3 days?
Doesn't mean I'm not a critic as well. Two things I don't like. People that don't trim their trees that knock the wires down and knock our electricity out. And two, why in the world is it so expensive when we have these big mega plants? Why is it so expensive?
I'm not the person to ask.
Because
that.
It's not about the customer anymore. It's about shareholders.
Yeah.
That's why.
That's the thing. It's like, how can you both have a single provider for X amount of a region? This is what you got. You got We Energies in California, you got PG&E. And this is like, if you want energy, this is what you got to, who you have to use. But then they're allowed to be a public company that is for profit and you don't have any choice. So they don't have to be accountable to you.
They have commissions, they have public meetings. That's all part of the process where we can weigh in. We have representatives in the legislature that can work with these. So there are avenues to do that. But there's been a fundamental shift in this country. It's not just this sector, it's everything. Away from customers and towards shareholders. Mm-hmm. Now, not everybody's a shareholder. If you're lucky, you are, and you can benefit from this stuff. But the mindset has changed in this country. The other one, of course, the easy one is CEO pay. I mean, I never begrudge people money. But when you see, for example, Dave Calhoun is running Boeing right now. He is going to leave with an umbrella package, which is incredible. Yeah. He has essentially created a safety hazard with some of his decisions at Boeing. And I don't care if Dave Calhoun likes it or not. That's dangerous. Shareholders versus customers. When I'm flying, I don't care about the shareholders. I care about the customer.
Well, it's also so funny to me of how often, follow me here, because this is not, I haven't thought about this before, but when we think about celebrities, right, and how, or even politicians and people who make a misstep, and because they are public figures, can't, quote unquote, cancel culture, right? And all of a sudden they can't get hired again because of public opinion about them. Then we have these CEOs who make, actually break the law sometimes, but also just make terrible decisions as far as that affects millions of consumers. And because they're not the same level of celebrity and we don't know them by name unless you're really following the news, they can kind of just like go away for a little while and shift back and get another multi-million dollar paycheck from being a CEO at a different company.
You could do a bad job, be a horrible CEO. Here's $10 million. Thanks for working for us.
That's on the low end.
Yeah. Here's $100 million. Calhoun's not going to be hurting. He's had some big jobs in his life.
It's almost like when you're a fired Bucks coach. You're like, oh, I still get to get paid for the next 2 years.
Well, that, you know, sports. Sports is great. Look, I understand these people are getting paid to lead a company. I get that. But at some point, good decision making should matter, not necessarily how big your umbrella package is when you leave.
I totally agree with you. See, look at us agreeing.
Yeah, that's a good thing.
Well, here's another agreement.
Yes.
Potato or egg when it comes to Easter?
Are you asking me right now?
Well, tee it up. So this is two different things. There's the PETA side of this story.
Don't care.
But there's also the cost side of this story, which was more of the case last year. Because if you remember last year, eggs were very, very expensive.
Oh, did I hear about that? $7
a
dozen.
This was the first time I heard of the alternative of, instead of dying eggs, you might die a potato. So we're going to talk about that when we come back. ABC News and local headlines are next.
ABC News, I'm Michelle Franzen. After Israel's prime minister canceled a delegation trip to the U.S. to discuss alternatives to military operations in Rafah, U.S. officials say that meeting is back on. White House Press Secretary Karine Jean-Pierre.
The prime minister's office has agreed to reschedule the meeting dedicated to Rafah. So we're now working with them to find a convenient date that's obviously going to work for both sides.
Israel's prime minister called off the delegation visit in response to the U.S. abstaining from a U.N. Security Council vote calling for a ceasefire in Gaza. In Baltimore, crews have shifted to recovery at that collapse of the Francis Scott Key Bridge site. Six workers on that span when the container ship slammed into a support pylon, now presumed dead. Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg says they're working to rebuild the bridge and reopen the port as soon as possible. Winter storms sweeping across the upper plains. This is ABC News.
Citing Unlimited WTMJ News Times 231. From the WTMJ Breaking News Center, I'm Mike Spaulding. A six-year-old boy is recovering today after his parents say he was struck by a stray bullet. Milwaukee police responding to reports of a child shot near 38th and Roar just after 9 o'clock Tuesday. When they arrived, the boy's parents told them that he was sitting in the home while playing video games when a bullet tore through the wall and he was struck. That boy is expected to make a full recovery. Milwaukee public school leaders pushing back against accusations that they don't have a plan should a $252 million referendum fail on Tuesday. MPS Superintendent Dr. Keith Posley telling WTMJ the referendum money would help the district keep elective classes such as art and music alive. Those in opposition of the referendum say the district's ask would put an undue burden on Milwaukee taxpayers. If passed, residents would pay about $216 for every $100,000 of home evaluation. Former President Donald Trump is set to make his way back to the Badger State in nearly 2 years. His campaign says he'll be at a campaign rally in Green Bay on Tuesday. That's also the day that voters head to the polls. And opening day will need to wait a day. The Brewers and Mets season opener that was supposed to be played tomorrow afternoon will now take place on Friday. The Brewers saying the postponement is due to rainy weather in New York. Broadcast time will be 12:05 Friday right here on WTMJ. Time now for some news about your money and the WTMJ Annex Wealth Management market update. The Dow up 354 at 39,636. The S&P 500's up 26 points at 5229. The NASDAQ up 23.5 points at 16,339. It's a great time for your retirement and investment strategy review from a fee-only fiduciary. Go to annexwealth.com and click the Get Started button today. Taking a look at your roads in your Johnson & Sons paving, time saver traffic. No major issues to speak of on the roadways. Things are moving smoothly across the system. Your WTMJ 5-day forecast, partly cloudy skies throughout the remainder of the afternoon. Mostly clear, chilly overnight tonight, a low 25. Tomorrow, sunny skies, a high 45 degrees. Friday, increasingly cloudy, rainy as well, a high 46 lakeside, 53 inland. Saturday, chance of morning rain shower, high 50 lakeside, 55 inland. And on Sunday, slight chance of a rain shower, mostly cloudy, a high of 44 degrees. Right now in Milwaukee, it's 39 degrees. I'm Mike Spaulding, citing Unlimited WTMJ News Times, 1234.
Heiser Ford has slam dunk lease deals this month. Score big on a 23 Bronco Sport or a 23 Escape with affordable leases starting at under $300 a month. Yes, under $300 a month. Plus, we will be awarding our MVPs with our exclusive Safe and Sound program, which is included on each vehicle sale. See all details at HeiserFord.com. At Heiser, today's your day.
See dealer for complete details. Tax, title, license, and $399 service fees extra. Ends March 31st.
Skilled trade workers are the backbone of every community and also the Army National Guard. Soldiers trained to keep the power flowing, engines running, and in every other trade needed to accomplish the mission. These soldiers are on the fast track to learning skills that can set them up for success at home with companies looking to hire the best. Their resumes are being built through their paid training and part-time service. Find out how you too can learn a trade profession by visiting NationalGuard.com. Sponsored by the Wisconsin Army National Guard. Aired by the Wisconsin Broadcasters Association and this station.
Folks, this is Hank Albert, owner of BBC Lighting. With spring in the air, a young man's fancy turns to ceiling fans. And at BBC, he'll see all the best quality fans and their newest styles. The new fan electronics provide a great method of moving air, and with LED lights, they use less electricity than ever. We have fans in all sizes, from 24 to 96 inches wide, and their motors are warranted for life. At BBC, we advise you on the right fan for your needs, and our prices are the lowest. I guarantee it. We're open Monday through Friday from 9 to 5 and on Saturday 10 to 4 and located at 20th and St. Paul Avenue across from Sobelman's and Bachman Furniture, all near the Pottawatomie Casino. Stay safe and healthy, my friends.
He had no hair.
Lost that shot, he was caught out there.
Saw the convertible driving by. Loaded up the slingshot.
Welcome back to Spanning the State. I am Kristen Bry here with Steve Scafidi, and it's Easter on Sunday. We already talked about your entire family. Both sides will be there.
Everybody.
My family is coming down from Wisconsin Rapids. Brother, parents.
Nice.
Finally getting some Frankie time.
Frankie will get all the attention.
Frankie now gets all of the attention.
That's
as
good.
The only grandchild on...
How old is Frankie now?
She's 6 months next week.
6 months.
Had our first stomach bug.
Oh.
This week that we're dealing
with. That's
hard. So... You know,
mom taking that okay?
We're okay. But yeah. It was a little bit of that first feeling of, oh my God, my baby's sick. I just want her to feel better.
You know what happens now? They get everything. And it becomes a norm. Like when they're not sick is. You know,
and then I'll start getting everything.
Yeah. And then the grandparents
get it. Wipe everything down in the studio so I don't get other people sick.
Oh, yeah.
All right. Well, like I said, Easter is on Sunday. It is Holy Wednesday. And you actually were the one who highlighted this to me. As far as potatoes versus eggs.
Yes.
So I saw it last year for a different reason. So last year, the price of eggs was astronomical, and there was suggestions of dying potatoes.
Shifting from one thing to another. Now, PETA was like all on board because, you know, an egg from a chicken versus a thing that grows in the ground, they're going to choose the thing that grows in the ground every time. Now, thinking about this from a functional perspective. Now, we were actually going to do like a whole setup.
So we were going to try to dye some potatoes.
Yeah.
And then we found out that dyeing potatoes is a little bit more labor intensive than dyeing an egg. You have to boil the potatoes. You got to clean the potatoes.
It's
nuts. Since this is an audio format, we didn't know if the payoff would really be there for us to show off our dyed potatoes at the end of the segment.
But then I thought about this. So we have competing interests. We have a lot of people with chickens in the States, so they've got the eggs. But as you know, being from Wisconsin Rapids, that plover area, the center of the state, that good sandy soil, like Orida's up there. This is the like the potato capital of Wisconsin. So wouldn't those growers say, hey, that might not be a bad idea?
Well, and actually, we have a clip from WIV4 Detroit that talked a little bit about potato farmer versus egg farmer.
On social media, as many are trying to avoid paying higher egg prices, potato growers, well, they love the idea and they're marketing, you know, potatoes USA across the board. They say it's a great idea for kids as taters are less fragile. One ended up cracked on your floor. Does this mean we're replacing the Easter Bunny with Mr. Potato Head? We have reached out to the Easter Bunny for comment and we have not heard back yet.
Kind of a snarky local reporter. I like that.
You like a little snark from
your
reporters?
Absolutely. Well, they're not as functional as eggs are. Eggs are uniform. Potatoes, now if you, I guess some varieties like Yukon Gold, they're all kind of the same shape and size.
And I think those are the ones that, at least the recipes we were looking at when we were going to try to do this.
Yeah, Yukon Gold.
Was saying Yukon Gold. Don't get a russet.
As a potato grower myself, that is one of the golden varieties. Because it's a potato. I'm going off track a little bit here, but I think it's important.
Go ahead.
It's a potato that actually, when you cook it, it tastes like it's already buttered. That's how good that potato is.
Okay.
Yukon Gold.
So here's my question. Do you think you could make, if you did both, if you had some dyed eggs and some dyed potatoes, and then you just have a very colorful omelet on Easter?
Yeah, interesting. So, I mean, the dye is the dye, right? But on the egg, you put the dye on the part you don't eat.
Yeah, you don't eat the shell.
So could you eat it? I suppose, because dye's dye. It's not going to hurt you.
Yeah. If you eat as many Skittles as I do, you know that dye is fine.
Yeah, and, you know, you can grow. I've grown purple potatoes that you don't even have to dye, and they're already purple inside and outside. So, I mean, that part you could actually already do. You wouldn't even have to dye them. You know, here's the thing I'm thinking about this now. Why would you dye them? There's red potatoes, there's purple potatoes, there's gold potatoes. You just take them naturally, and that's your color.
And that's your ambiance.
Why didn't we think of that? And I, as a potato grower, I should have known that.
I also just don't think, like, when do you stop dyeing the eggs? And when do you start? So as we just said, Frankie's 6 months old. Like, when do I have to start doing the magic of Easter a mom?
You know, year two, probably, because 1 year, maybe they won't even know what an egg is. Two, yeah, they know what an egg is.
And so you have to start dyeing them, and you have to start doing the Easter egg hunt and all those
things.
I'm
thinking like seven.
You ever did an adult Easter egg hunt?
No.
Do you know what it is?
Not really.
So in the same way, you know, an Easter egg hunt for a kid,
you put
candy, maybe put some coins in the little plastic eggs when they find it.
Right.
You put
Alcohol?
You can put little shooters in there.
I can see that, yeah.
You can put bigger dollar bills in there.
You participated in one of these?
One year I did an adult Easter egg hunt, and it was very fun.
I didn't even know that was a thing, so I'm not going to...
Maybe
I'm not
you can do it
thumbs.
This weekend.
No, I'm not going to do this
with
weekend.
With the whole family.
It's too soggy outside. I mean, I don't want to be outside. It's too wet. It's too wet out there. I was up at 3 o'clock in the morning reconnecting my sump pump hose.
So maybe that's why it's so soggy.
Well, probably helped.
All right. Well, when we come back, tip it forward. A Waukesha man got a very large tip on a pretty affordable haircut. So we will talk about that when we come back. This is Spanning the State on WTMJ.
Do you want the economy mulch or the premium? The only real difference is that the premium mulch has thicker strands, while the economy mulch is finer. But the colorant we use for both is of the highest quality, and that's why the color of our mulch lasts longer. And our mulch comes from trees, not pallets, and we process it all in-house. That's why our prices are so low. Erickson's Landscape Supply, high-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less. Commercial or residential, visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection. At Erickson's Landscape Supply, we have durable, maintenance-free polywood patio furniture and number one grade treated natural pine Amish-made patio furniture. And we also have a wonderful assortment of concrete benches, statues, and fountains available in a selection you just gotta see to believe. Erickson's Landscape Supply, high-quality mulch and stone for a whole lot less, plus a whole lot more. Commercial or residential, visit ericksonslandscapesupply.com to see our entire selection or stop on in today.
If there's any one thing that matters most to home sellers, it's their real estate agent getting as close to their asking price as possible. This is Angela Calais with Benefit Realty, and here's a fact that should get you to think twice before calling anyone else. Statistics reveal Benefit Realty's list price to sale price ratio is over 100%. When you choose Benefit Realty, we're working as hard as we can to get you all that we can. Get proven performance and full service, all for only 3.9% real estate commissions. Benefit-realty.com. This is Angela Calais with Benefit Realty. When it comes to getting the peak price for your home sale, it's all a matter of eyeballs. The more people we get your home listing in front of, the more opportunities arise. At Benefit Realty, we are ultra confident in promising you maximum exposure to your listing. We want to sell it fast and for as much as we can for you. That way, all sides win. And I have to believe that's why we've achieved the strong growth that we have. Maximum exposure means maximum home sale value. Benefit-realty.com.
Flooring, carpeting, bath, or kitchen remodeling. Adair is the name Milwaukee has trusted for 65 years. This is Rob Adair. Ready to remodel? Give us a call, 761-3660. Get personal care from Adair, South 27th in Franklin.
Acunet Mortgage is an equal housing lender, NMLS ID 255368.
Steve and Ashley heard our radio ads over the years, and when it came time to buy their first home, clicked on the blue button. One of our senior loan consultants, Brad, sent them a credit-verified pre-approval the same day and then upgraded to a rock-solid, fully verified and guaranteed pre-approval shortly thereafter. They made a couple offers without success, and then Brad told them about Acunet's new property-specific pre-approval, where we might be able to include those magic words, no appraisal required. When they wrote their next offer, several thousand dollars over asking to make sure someone else didn't end up sleeping in their dream home, their property-specific rock-solid guaranteed pre-approval included that most powerful phrase, no appraisal required, and the sellers picked Steve and Ashley's offer over several others. If you think all mortgage lenders and pre-approvals are the same, think again. Go with a local mortgage lender that has the tools and know-how to help you win and save money, too. Click on the blue button today at accunet.com.
Welcome back to Spanning the State. I am Kristen Bry here with Steve Scafidi. Steve, what is the, were you ever a service industry person where you were receiving tips?
Bartender, yeah. Many years.
Did you ever have someone come in and just leave you a huge tip that you were like, thanks, man?
I mean, this is back a ways because this, you know, probably the late 70s, early 80s into the 90s, early 90s, $20 tops maybe.
I got $50 once when I was a hostess at a restaurant and he was kind of a sleazeball, but still, it got on the table that he wanted.
Oh.
And he gave me $50 and at 18, I didn't hate it.
No, I mean, my wife was a waitress. My daughters were waitresses. They had some big tips. Like, what's one of those wow, like, what would be a wow tip?
Well, I think the wow tip is a story that just happened in Waukesha,
that
right?
was my setup for you.
Thank you.
Did you get that?
So I saw this from WISN had this story recently. So there was a barber named Chris Davis, and a unknown customer, anonymous man, walked in a suit and left him a $1,000 tip on a $30 haircut.
That's a wow tip.
That is a wow tip. That is rent.
Yeah, that like I've never done anything like that.
I wish I could do that. If I was really rich, that is the kind of stuff that I would just be like, here you go. Peace out. You're welcome.
If you're that guy in Jersey that just won the, was it Mega Millions, Millions or Powerball, one of the two, single winner, one ticket, man or woman, I'm that person. You're all, I'm going to have hundreds that I'm just going to hand out like singles.
That or be able to go to different, if you ever get invited to a gala or a fundraiser and being the, get the big ticket thing and be able to just be like, oh, sure, 10,000, whatever. But WISN had a clip and they talked to Chris Davis about what an unexpected surprise this tip was.
I asked him what he was doing because he had a suit on. So I assumed, you know, he had a wedding or something.
Davis didn't see the tip until after the man left.
My heart dropped right away, and I wish I could have went out and thanked him, but he was already gone. A tip like that is so unheard of. You know, that's just a blessing right there. It just lets me know that there's really good people in the world that do a lot of good things for other people. It just makes me continue to want to make people feel good myself.
It's a feel-good story.
It's a feel-good story. We love stories like that, but
now,
whew.
Now, my hair, I used to have a woman that cut my hair probably for 15 to 20 years. And it wasn't one of those high-end places, but it was like $15. But because I really appreciated the way she cut my hair, I would give her like three times what the cost was. So that's a wow tip, right?
That is a wow tip.
But it still only cost me, if it was 15, it was 45. But it was worth it because the haircut was that good. And then she moved to Florida. And I hate her.
Because she left you? You had to find a new person to cut those luscious locks?
Now, there's another part of that story.
Okay.
So my wife, Kathy, whose dad was a barber for many years, four decades, she cuts my hair now, and she costs me zero. So, and she does a pretty good job.
There you go.
So, although I always say, do you want me to tip you? And every once in a while, she says yes. And I do.
What's the tip on zero?
I Venmo her like $10.
Okay. That's a pretty high markup.
And I put haircut on the Venmo notation.
The best tip story, I think, and it's not, I wish I could claim it, but I won't. Our good friend Joe, when he got his stimulus money, he was like, whatever. And so we were at Broad House on 3rd Street.
Oh, yeah.
And he just signed over $600 as a check. We were there for a Packers Sunday, just hanging out. And he just left because they pool tips there. And so the bartender saw it, and she just immediately, she's like, started tearing up and gave him a hug. And he's the kind of guy where he's just like, this makes me uncomfortable. Like, please don't acknowledge that I just did that.
Yeah, yeah.
And so that was very
generous.
That's
the best, though.
Yeah.
Because you made someone's year.
Yeah.
Life.
I mean, $1,000 for someone.
That's a big deal.
It's, when we say people don't necessarily even have $400 in the bank for an emergency, $1,000 goes a long way for a lot of people.
That's why I always say, you know, so many of these howdies that we sell, it's about giving something up or, you know, whatever, resolutions to give. Your resolution should be to do something for someone else.
Yeah.
Always. And if it's financial, that's cool. If you can afford it, knock yourself out. Even if it's just doing something. Find something positive. Don't give stuff up. Do something positive.
There's also a lot of social science that it makes you, the giver, feel a lot better.
And healthier.
All right. Well, when we come back, you have been keeping up with the Amazing Race. You're going to give us check-in on how our firefighting Wisconsin ladies are doing. News time 2:50. This is Spanning the State.
Woo! Hey, this is Ben Brust from Kyle Brust and Ortman on ESPN Wisconsin. People can't stop screaming about the Screaming Sicilian Frozen Pizza, and no wonder, there's plenty to scream about, like the buttery stone-fired crust, secret recipe tomato sauce, mounds of whole milk mozzarella, and tons of premium toppings. Find Screaming Sicilian in your local grocer's freezer and find out for yourself why Sporked called Screaming Sicilian's Holy Pepperoni Frozen Pizza the best of the best. Screaming Sicilian. Taste what all the screaming is about.
Hey, boaters!
At Kendor Marine, we have everything you could want, think of, or wish for your boat.
We're committed to making sure you always have a place to fulfill every boating need that you have. And if you ask around, you'll find out our prices always beat the other guys. This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. Boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey boaters, cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water. Hey boaters!
This is Dave Doro from Kendor Marine. And hey, boaters love shopping here. How do I know? Well, most times it's because they tell me, Dave, I love shopping here. But other times, it's because they tell you. If you need a reason to come here, just check out our online reviews. They tell the whole story. Boaters in the know exactly where to go. Kendor Marine, 57th Ryan Road in Franklin.
Hey boaters! Cruise to Kendor Marine. We got everything you need but the water.
The Midwest's best baseball and softball training facility and retail center is here in New Berlin, and it's ready for you and your team. From little leaguers to hardcore players and training.